Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Michael Linares, and I will be your host for the ICP 5 test questions of the day. You have the opportunity, that's right, you the contestant, have the opportunity to answer these 5 test questions for ICP for your next test, and they probably will be on your next test. Question number 1.
Okay.
I should have been an announcer, huh? Okay, guys, we're going to go into the 5 test questions for ICP that will probably be on your test, okay? So let's go through it really quick. I know your book is huge and you need to know everything in nursing school, but let's go through the top 5 that is probably going to be on your test here. So number 1 here, you have a change. I'm giving you the answers already, huh? You have a change. That little triangle means change. You have a change in your GCS scale, your Glasgow Coma Scale. And if you haven't seen the video on that, I suggest you guys watch it. We even have a Glasgow Coma Scale dance. If you guys have a change, when do you tell the doctor? Think. When do you tell the doctor? Okay. You tell the doctor on 2 instances here. In the first 48 hours, if there is a change, good or bad, if your Glasgow Coma Scale is going up, it's a great thing. You tell the doctor, call the doctor ASAP, very immediately, okay? If you have a patient going down in that first 48 hours, a GCS going down, call the doctor. The doctor needs to know this is priority in terms of your care. Or, let's say it's past 48 hours. The patient's been in a, let's say, coma. They've been in a GCS, like less than 8. They have an endotracheal tube, a tube going into their lungs, breathing for them. But the patient keeps on going down in terms of their GCS neuro checks. That is another instance you call the doctor, okay? If the patient is getting better, that's a good thing. But in the first 48 hours, good or bad, you call the doctor. After the 48 hours, we expect the patient to get better, hopefully, if we're doing the right medications and nursing interventions. But if the patient is spiraling down, give the doctor a call. Any change in neuro status in the first 48 hours, give the doctor a call. All right. Next, number 2. When do you give an endotracheal tube? When do you put a tube in someone's patient? When do you put a tube in your patient? Which scale, which number in terms of your GCS? And I just gave it away in the last one. Anything less than 8 usually gets trached. We put a tube in. And the GCS, anything less than 8 means that your patient is high critical and will probably be in the neuro ICU. So, that's a big one. Number 3, positioning your patient. I'm giving you the answers here, dang it. Number 3 is positioning your patient. What do you want to make sure? The 3 things you want to make sure when you're positioning your patient. 3 things. Come on. 3 things. Give it to me. Come on. Tell me. 3, 2, 1. Okay. You want to keep your patient neutral. No bending the neck. Don't position your patient any flexing type of motions, okay? Keep your patient neutral. 30 degrees, head of the bed up to help the drainage from the cerebrum. Or the cerebral drainage. You want to log roll your patient when you're moving them, basically keeping the patient in one line. So if you're gonna log roll them, that means someone is holding the head and someone is moving the body. So if you're gonna clean your patient, you have to coordinate with one of your allied health, one holding the head, and you say 1, 2, 3, turn, clean it all up down there, and then 1, 2, 3, turn, patient's back down, okay? Log roll, that's huge. And no flexing, like I said, no flexing. So no bending the arms, no bending the legs, no matrix here. So I said no matrix. All right, no kung fu action. All right? Ain't nobody got time for that. Okay. Number four. Increased CO2 levels. Increased carbon dioxide levels. What is the number that we want to watch for? We know that increased CO2 dilates blood vessels in the brain. So we don't want that. We want to decrease the amount of circulation going to the brain because we don't want to cause any more increase in pressure. So what's that number? What is the number we're looking for in terms of having your patient in a good therapeutic range? What is the number less than? Come on. Tell me. If you guys don't know your ABGs, then you probably won't get this one right. So normally in an ABG, anything between 3.5-4.5 millimeters of mercury is your, I'm sorry, millimeters of mercury. Microequivalents of carbon dioxide is your regular. So anything greater than 40 is kind of the rule of thumb in the hospitals. Now in your book and on your test, 3.5 to 4.5 is normal. So anything greater than probably 45 is considered a hazard. In the hospital, we like to keep it underneath the borderline for being high. We want to get the CO2 as low as possible to keep your patient in an alkalotic state, in an oxygenized state, not a lot of acid, okay? Next, do you cluster your care with your ICP patients? Now, your patient's probably in a coma, your patient's trait. Do you cluster your care? If you guys are like, what the heck is clustering care? Then you probably didn't go through pediatrics yet, or newborn assessment yet. Because clustering care basically means that you're going in and you're doing all the care at specific times instead of constantly going in and bothering your patient, okay? So do you cluster your care, group your activities together, or does it matter? What do you think? I put yes or no. It's kind of a trick question. What do you think? All right. Yes and no, actually. So yes, you cluster your neuro checks. Your neuro checks must be done depending on your hospital. If you have a newly admitted ICP patient that's less than 48 hours old, usually we're doing neuro checks every like either 15 minutes or every hourly basis. Now, depending on your patient, we're going to be doing neuro checks. So we're not clustering the care for neuro checks in terms of your GCS, just because we don't want your patient to spiral down. Okay, so now what don't we cluster? I'm sorry, do we cluster care? Yes, in terms of our neuro, but no, we're not bothering our patient on a regular basis. So we're going to cluster our ADLs, we're going to cluster our patients' like feeding times. We can monitor your patient outside of the ICU doors. We can do our oral, basically ADLs, clean your patient up. But we're clustering our care like every 4 hours in terms of that kind of information. But neuro checks, we do not cluster, okay? Cool. All right. So let's go into our GCS quiz next.